In this video, we're going to take a look at how easy it is to use Digibee to build integrations using our pipeline canvas. For this quick demonstration, we're going to start by ingesting a file that contains perhaps a list of orders, which we can see here in CSV form. We're going to ingest that, and then we're going to insert that into our database so that we can use it in other ways as well. We're going to start by going over here to the Create button and adding a new pipeline. Once we're inside of the canvas, we always want to start with a trigger. So when is this going to be initiated? In this case, let's set it on a recurring basis. We have some handy out-of-the-box schedulers right here. Let's say this is once a day. I'm going to kick this off at midnight. And it's as simple as that. Once we deploy, this will run every night at midnight. Now we need to start by downloading that file. So from the components over here on the right-hand side, I can do an HTTP download, drag that onto my canvas, connect the components, and put in the URL. For my file. And for this scenario, we're going to save that as a local file because we're going to manipulate and extract the data from that file here within the pipeline. So we're going to give it a simple name, textorders.txt. Now we can go ahead and start testing right away. It's very easy to test your pipeline as you're building it within Digibee. So clicking this test icon, I can come in here and hit play and see if we're able to download that file. So it looks like we were able to download it. We've generated a file called textorders.txt, and our success was true here. Keep in mind that success true, that'll come in later as well. The next thing we need to do is take this data that was in a CSV and over to JSON. The way that Digibee works is each component is passing JSON from one step to the next. So we want to get that into JSON so that we can work on that easily within the following components. So we're going to convert to JSON. And we already have this CSV as a file. And we have the name already decided. And I happen to know that this CSV does have headers. So we just need the delimiter, which is a comma, and we can hit confirm. Now, if we hit play again, we should see what was within that. So now we can see that we have an array called data, and inside of that we have order and value for each one of several hundred order values. The next thing I want to do is I want to work on getting that inserted into a database, but I want to do that for each row. So we can use the for each function for each element of this array, drag that on, connect those, and within the configuration of my for each function, if we recall, our path was $.data. So data is our array. So it's looking for what array is going to be executing this for each loop. And now these blocks here, these pink icons, these always have a sub pipeline. So now I'm going to go inside and say, what am I doing for each element of this array? This on process. So now we're inside of the insert to DB for each loop inside of my original pipeline, which I haven't named yet. And within here, I just want to grab my database component, drag that onto the screen, connect in, and go ahead and configure where I'm going to put this. I already have my credentials defined for this SQL account, and I just need to point it to the right database. In this case, it's called on-prem DB. And then add in the SQL statement for how I want these inserted. I happen to have that ready to go. And you'll see that what we're doing is inserting into the request table. We're adding in the order, the value, and a timestamp value, which we're going to actually create on the fly. So we're adding the timestamp by just using our functions over here on the right-hand side. So if we ever need to modify strings as we're building this, we can always use these functions on the right-hand side to do things like generate the current date, now reformat that date using our format date, and that's what we're doing here is using these double brace expressions. The other thing that we use these double brace expressions for is actually calling the variables from the previous steps. As I mentioned before, each component is just taking JSON from the previous one and calling it in order to use that data in new ways. Here we can see that by calling message dot and then the value I want, so message indicates the previous component has the JSON in it, and then message.order, message.value, those are the values we want to get from that previous component. So now, if we go ahead and hit play, what we should see is 204 outputs occurred. And right now these say failure on them because we have not set the success equal to true within this pipeline down here. So we don't know if each execution was successful or not because we haven't told it. So let's go ahead and add in one final step that's going to set a successful output. And this is called our JSON generator, which allows you to just write whatever JSON you'd like within it. So in this case, we're just looking to set our output to true. So our success is true if we make it to this point. And if these error out, it actually goes to a separate path that we can also put in custom error text if we need to. But for now, we know this is going to be successful. And so now by inserting it again and hitting the play button again, you can see that we have 204 successes. And indeed, as a final check, if we head over to our database here, I'm looking at the request table. Let's go ahead and refresh it. It's empty right now, but if I refresh, there's all the records that we just inserted with their timestamps and corresponding values. Thank you for taking a look at this quick and easy example of building a pipeline within Digibee.